Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. Good morning to everybody. As a good tradition, I would just like to hand over the microphone to our two youth delegates who are now going to speak on their own behalf.
Mr. Chair, honorable delegates, young people are often referred to as the youth, which is expected to have similar opinions and views on politics. But the youth is as diverse as society is. Young people have as different experiences and lives as anyone else. But young people have also progressive and creative ideas and visions on how the future should look like and how to tackle problems already today. And if you take time to actually listen carefully, young people are very inspiring. Having listened to many young people from all over Germany for the past year, we want to share their visions and ideas with you. We invite you to close your laptops and put aside your cell phones for a minute and let yourself be inspired by the passionate and innovative ideas and visions of the young people we've met. As different as their opinions on specific topics were, as unified they were in describing a very clear vision of a society where everyone has the same rights and chances, no matter where you're born or raised, no matter which nationality you have, and no matter you plan to grow old in the country you're currently staying at, or move back to your home country as soon as those conflicts are over that made you leave once. Young people appreciate intercultural exchange and dialogue. And don't you do that too? Imagine a world where borders are lines on maps instead of walls and fences. A world in which your passport doesn't decide on which countries you can travel to, but where you can travel to any country, get to know any culture, and meet any nationality's people, no matter where you're starting your journey. Young people share a vision of a society where same rights and chances are a reality rather today than tomorrow. Where it doesn't matter which gender you identify with, be it male, female, or neither of these two. Young people desperately hope for you to overcome the gender binary, but include all identities when taking action for gender equality. Same goes for sexual orientation. Young people just want to be treated as being free and equal, to cite the UN for LGBT equality campaign. Honorable delegates, how did you imagine your life as a child? Following your passions, finding a good job, marrying and having a family? Imagine you found the love of your life, the person you want to have children with. But you're not allowed to marry that person because marriage is withheld from you. Wouldn't you want the international community to fight for you?
Mr. Chair, the two of us would probably not be here without the skills we learned in context of non-formal education and our experiences in youth organizations. Of course, we attended school for the majority of our lifetime and we are university students right now. But we are also active members in NGOs that educate young people in various fields to become active global citizens. Facing today's challenges, education for sustainable development gains importance every day. The 2030 Agenda and its Sustainable Development Goals are a motivation for many NGOs to take action for more sustainable communities in all regions of the world. Imagine a world in which every person is able to be a leader in sustainable development, in which every person supports the vision of the 2030 Agenda because they have the skills needed to do so, and in which every person lives a sustainable life because they fully understand the importance of it. Wouldn't that be wonderful? Therefore, we would like to invite you to take the three following first steps. First, guarantee the same rights to all human beings, not because of their gender, race, nationality, or sexual orientation, but because they are human. And as it states in Article 1 of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, all human beings are born free and equal in dignity and rights. They are endowed with reason and conscience and should act towards one another in a spirit of brotherhood. Second, establish a strong and valid participation of youth in national contexts and at the UN. For example, by establishing a UN Youth Delegate Program. But this is only the first step, because on a long term, we need country representatives to be as diverse as society is, and by that, also include more young people. Third, support youth organizations that are providing young people with skills already today to make their work more recognized and let them help to reach the SDGs in your country. Help them to include sustainable development in their work and to provide skills for future jobs that do not even exist today. Just one last thing. Whenever you want to take an important decision, take a moment to rest and think. Have I consulted with the generation that this decision will affect? Have they been at the negotiating table, and are they part of the decision-making process? If you can answer all these questions with an undoubtful yes, congratulations. If not, adjust and take action to get the missing perspectives on board. They are worth it. We thank you.